Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the psoas minor muscle.
Pictured here we can see the psoas minor muscle in isolation. And the psoas minor muscle is one of the three iliopsoas muscles. The other two are the psoas major muscle and the iliacus muscle. A difference you'll notice between these three muscles is that the psoas major and the iliacus here both cross over the hip joint, whereas the psoas minor is connecting onto the hip here. I think this is why some sources don't include the psoas minor as part of the iliopsoas muscle group, but most of the research papers and textbooks that I've looked at included the psoas minor as part of this muscle group, so I'm going to include it in this video as well. Another thing you'll notice about the psoas minor muscle here is that it's more superficial than the psoas major and the iliacus, superficial meaning closer to the skin surface. So the psoas major and the iliacus are both deep to that psoas minor muscle. Another major landmark to look at is the inguinal ligament here, which you can see I've just brought into the picture. And you'll notice all of these iliopsoas muscles are deep to the inguinal ligament. The last thing to note about the psoas minor muscle is you can see this lighter coloured area here, and the lighter coloured area of the muscle represents the muscle tendon, and with the psoas minor muscle it's been estimated that this distal tendon accounts for around 57% of the total muscle's length. So let's take a look at the origin next, and you can see I've got that highlighted here in red either side of the vertebrae. I've also labelled the vertebrae. The L's would be lumbar and the T would be the thoracic vertebrae. And you can see this red area spans onto the vertebral body of T12, onto the vertebral body of L1, and it's also crossing onto this adjacent intervertebral disc as well. So that origin point is going to be on the vertebral bodies of T12, L1, and the adjacent intervertebral disc. So next you can see I've highlighted the insertion in blue either side here, and that insertion is going to be on the iliopectineal eminence and also the pectineal line. So the iliopectineal eminence is going to be more towards the lateral side of this blue area here, and it's going to be a ridge on the top of the hip bone, and it marks the junction of the ilium and the pubis, whereas the pectineal line is more towards this medial side, which I've got marked out here, and it's a line spanning down this section here, or rather it's a ridge on the superior ramus of the pubic bone. And the amount that insertion falls on either of those two areas is going to depend on the person, so one person's insertion may fall more onto the iliopectineal eminence and the other one might be a little bit more towards the pectineal line. Bear in mind, some people are missing this muscle entirely, so there is a bit of individual variation there.
So let's take a look at the actions next. Now the psoas major muscle crosses over the hip joint here, so psoas major is going to have actions at the hip joint, but the psoas minor muscle doesn't cross the hip joint. Instead, it's just connecting the hip to the vertebrae, so its actions are going to be limited in this area right here. So as it contracts, it can pull the vertebrae towards the hip or the hip towards the vertebrae, and that's going to result in flexion of the trunk, which would be this sort of a movement, just like that. Now this flexion of the trunk which it causes is really weak comparative to other muscles like the rectus abdominis, for example. And to put it in perspective, if someone's missing one side of the psoas minor muscle, or say they're missing their psoas minor muscle entirely, it doesn't cause any functional problems. There's no sort of medical conditions it causes or anything like that to do with it being missing. Instead, other muscles are able to quite easily pick up the role of that missing psoas minor and just take over in its absence. So if you want to learn more about the psoas major muscle, check out the link in the description box below to that psoas major muscle video. If you've enjoyed this psoas minor muscle video, or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like, subscribe, hit the notification bell. Thanks again for watching, everyone. See you all next time.